something that God really pressed upon my heart was that I was supposed to slow down and really reflect on the things that I was doing. And it really allowed for a space for Him to move in. So I grew up in a Christian household. My entire family has always been very involved in the church, but I've always seen myself as an outsider. I was 14 when I stopped going to church with my family. I decided that I wanted to step out and do my own thing. When I was 19, I was a pedestrian that was struck by a car. He was a drunk driver. It changed my life dramatically. I was able to go back to school for about a year and a half. I had to relearn how to do a lot of things. I'm someone that's very independent, and I don't like to give up control. So it was very difficult for me to have to learn to rely on a lot of people. Before that car accident, I was very stubborn, and I wanted to have things done a certain way. There was a sense of immediacy for everything that I wanted. I was in a really long relationship with someone, and when that dissolved, I felt like I didn't have much of a community, and I didn't have a sense of friends or anyone surrounding me, and I was really at a place where I felt very hopeless. It was the first time in my adult life that I was living a slow enough life that He could come in there and that He could speak to me. And I think after that was the first time I'd ever tried going to a church on my own. I came to C3 through an Instagram post that my sister sent me, and I don't even know how I got there, to be honest, but I was really relying on a faith that I didn't feel, but a faith that I felt around me. I met so many people, and it was very overwhelming, but in the best way possible. I felt like I was embraced the second I walked in. It felt normal, even though I didn't know anyone. It was, oh, hey, Deborah, like, nice to meet you. Like, you're part of this family. Like, I had already felt like they had known me. Looking back in retrospect, I truly believe that God has always had a very heavy hand in my life, and that I have learned that I can't do everything on my own, and that I don't have to.